Hi guys, this is probably one of the last videos I'll be recording today on this topic, leading up to our hearing at Bombay High Court, which probably will happen tomorrow, but there's a possibility that the hearing won't happen tomorrow and we will get another date. Still, in case we are muzzled tomorrow, I would like to post this video late, no matter how late it is tonight. So I would like to acknowledge that I am being guided by an international expert on drywall technology, and he has been educating me a lot about what exactly is wrong with Lodha NCP drywalls. That's the gypsum board walls. Earlier, I used to think that it is wrong to have gypsum board as walls. It is only used for false ceilings. I stand corrected on that. Gypsum board can be used on walls. However, it has to be installed correctly. The reason I am able to bash through these walls and punch a hole right through a wall is because it is not installed correctly with the right support framework. And so I have, I'm correcting this, I'm setting the record straight on this. It is abundantly clear that Lodha has not installed the drywall properly, which is why it has all these issues, particularly its extreme weakness and its complete inability to sustain even an ordinary punch. If it were installed correctly as per the manufacturer's specifications, then very probably it would put up with my punch a lot better, and it is likely that I would injure myself trying to punch through that wall. I'm going to read this letter from Mr. Matthew Thomas, who is the international expert guiding me. His name is not really Matthew Thomas. This is just a pseudonym he has adopted because he chooses to remain anonymous. So Mr. Matthew Thomas writes to Mr. Krishnaraj Rao, January 19, 2019. I have been involved in senior level management in the drywall industry, both in South Africa and Europe, for over 20 years, and would like to highlight certain items to you regarding your drywall videos, more specifically titled Lodha NCP Punching Holes in Duro Wall. The use of drywall in a residential tower would not be considered an unusual form of construction. It would be standard in many countries, but alarmingly, the construction of the partitions in your video bring to light some questions regarding the gypsum partitions shown and the way they have been installed. If the partition had been installed correctly, it would not have been so easy to punch through them, as there would be a steel support member at all the required positions on the board. This is shown at minute 1.52 in this video. There are very clear guidelines from each manufacturer as to how the partitions should be installed, and when followed correctly, should provide a quality, robust finish. In the video you have shown where the horizontal joints of the boards are, there is a missing cross member in the steel framing. This cross member is not only required for strength, it is required to enable the correct placement of the screw fixing at the centers around the perimeter and joint of the board as specified by the manufacturers. This is not an optional element in the partition framework. It is expressly specified by the system manufacturer. This is shown at 1.52 minutes into the video. It is clearly visible at 1.58 minutes to 2.19 minutes in the busting Lodha wall video that the gypsum board have been installed incorrectly. The gypsum boards on opposing sides of the wall have not been staggered on alternate studs. This indicates that the joints of the board are on the same stud on both sides of the wall. This is contrary to all manufacturers' installation guidelines globally, as it diminishes the durability of the partition, and in a fire-rated partition assembly would be considered unacceptable. Depending on the manufacturer, the specifications will change slightly, but the theory remains the same, as this is how the partitions will have been laboratory tested for fire and acoustic properties. Installation outside the manufacturer's guidelines is not recommended, and it diminishes the performance of the partition in both fire rating and acoustic properties. You mentioned that the material used is Saint Gobain, bracket 1.27 minutes, which is the leading manufacturer of construction material, and in this case, drywall and metal supplier. However, it is a prerequisite in the installation guide of this manufacturer that the screw centers are at a maximum of 300 mm and have this noggin channel in place. Without this noggin channel, the required fixing centers cannot be maintained, and therefore the partition performance will be affected. Has the noggin channel been missed in this location or omitted totally throughout? As it does not appear to be installed in either partition in any of the videos I have witnessed. At 152 minutes into the first video and 0.17 seconds in the second video, it can be seen that there is no noggin channel in place. The socket and switch installation adheres to no manufacturer's installations guidelines, and as such meets no standard, as it appears to be a section of floor track that has been crudely adapted to support a switch. As this is an untested method of installation, it is very likely that a leading brand of drywall material supplier would accept this. It is very unlikely that a leading brand of drywall material supplier would accept this as a quality installation of their product to support an electrical outlet. All manufacturers have a design detail for installation of electrical outlets, and this has not been followed in the installation that you have presented. My main concern would turn to the installation of fire compartmentation partitions of the building. Moreover, this being the fire rated partitions and the shaft wall fire rated partitions that form the passive fire protection throughout the building through resistance to heat and flame and maintain the fire line for the required time. Partitions between flats, known as party walls, and common areas like lift waiting lobbies must carry a severe duty rating. These partitions, when constructed correctly, will provide a fire resistance of 120 minutes. Constructed incorrectly, the resistance time to fire is unknown. It is clear from the video titled "How Safe Are Lodha Flats from Thieves and Moisture" that there is a large hole through a fire-rated drywall partition that forms what appears to be a fire-rated service riser that travels vertically outside and somewhat inside the flat. There is no passive fire protection applied to this penetration, and the same location, bracket, this is shown at 1.15 and 1.20 minutes. Does not seem to have a fire rated door mounted in the opening to form the fire line. This is shown at 0.44 seconds. It would be imperative that the fire compartmentation here is maintained if this is where the fire line is. In this location or any other location where there are unknown or unplanned penetrations in a fire rated partition like this one previously discussed, like the one previously discussed, smoke and or flame can pass through this penetration into the void. This makes the drywall fire rated partition in this location obsolete, As it is unable to provide the required resistance, penetrations like this must be identified and sealed correctly. Having penetrations in firewalls like this permits the passage of fire from room to room within a flat, or worse, beyond the defined fire compartment. Fire compartmentation is an essential element in high-rise construction, and it is essential that it is maintained and installed correctly, whether it is block slash brick, fire stopping, or fire rated drywall partition. Drywall fire compartmentation drawings are used worldwide. They should be available to view on the plans of this structure with clearly defined fire lines. Is this the case in other locations also? This would require a full inspection from an independent observer to guarantee that there have not been any more exposed openings in firewalls like the one in the video. Not just in fire rated partitions, but block work and slab partitions that go from floor to floor vertically. From the video titled Sewage Pipes and Fire Hazards Inside Bedrooms. In relation to the room inside the master bedroom, from that carries to sewer pipes vertically, In relation to the room inside the master bedroom, from that carries sewer slash water pipes vertically through the building, it is important that the passage of fire cannot travel from flat to flat. At 0.28, it shows that the flat owner is standing on a metal grate with penetrations. A similar metal grate is shown at 1.28 above at the level of the upstairs neighbor's flat. In this location, there is no passive fire protection preventing transfer of fire to the adjoining flat. Can you confirm that this is a fire door on this sewer slash water slash service riser? And how many flats are exposed vertically like this? There should be passive fire protection in the form of a blockwork wall, fire rated partition, or fire rated mortar between each floor at slab level as passive fire protection to prevent the vertical movement of fire throughout the structure. My concern would be that a fire in the master bedroom or anywhere in the flat could simply transfer to the apartment above through this service duct as it is currently shown, or several flats if there is no fire protection. I would highlight these issues to a fire officer that would be accountable in case of fire. In case of fire, unlike water, fire does not give a second chance. I would strongly recommend that access is gained to the ceiling void above the false ceiling for the above reasons, as they are commonly omitted, and by these omissions the fire ratings of walls are compromised and acoustic properties are made redundant. Number 1. Do the gypsum boards that are on all partitions continue up to the slab level at the top and not just below the level of the false ceiling? Otherwise, there is a free flow of smoke and flame within the ceiling cavity. Number 2. Are there any penetrations in the fire-rated drywall partitions that have not been sealed and are hidden within the ceiling void? If so, these will accommodate the transmission of fire and must be identified and addressed. Number 3. Has the metal ceiling frame that supports the gypsum boards been installed to the manufacturer's guidelines? Number 4. Have the correct fixings been used into the concrete slab? have the correct metal components been used in the assembly? Have the correct number of components been used in the assembly? And are the components at the correct centers to maintain the stability of the ceiling frame? Have the correct number of metal-to-metal screw fixings been used in the support hangers? This is mandatory to maintain ceiling performance to prevent ceiling sag and possibly ceiling failure. A detailed independent review would be conducted on, should be conducted, a detailed independent review should be conducted on the actual installation of the false ceilings and partitions and compared to the manufacturer's installation guidelines and an audit produced. Number 5. Importantly, have the correct number of fixings been used in the correct locations to maintain the system stability, and have the correct fixings been used for each component. Please note, on a previous review of the ceiling installation in New Cuff Parade, the false ceilings had not been installed to the manufacturer's installation guidelines. While requesting my privacy is respected, please be assured that I have detailed knowledge of the global drywall industry, and I have made several visits to this particular project, not just one tower on the project, but 3 towers in total in New Cuff Parade. The towers I attended had a combination of different drywall material manufacturers. One particular tower had an installation of unbranded metal components that were not being installed to any drywall manufacturer's guidelines and had not taken into account even the basic principles of drywall partition assembly. Components being used in an ad hoc, untested manner that contravened drywall norms. I believe the non-compliance of drywall partition installation guidelines and possibly the ability of, just a minute, let me get my cat out of the way. I believe the non-compliance to drywall partition installation guidelines and possibly the inability of the installation team has led to the resulting quality issues in NCP. While Lodha may be a big brand, ultimately their quality can only be as good as the subcontractors that they have used for the actual work. Having a large brand ambassador is all good and well, but does he know how the pipe work has been installed and tested? And does he know the drywall has been installed and has the passive fire protection been complete? Although a fabulous cricketer, I would not like Virat Kohli to do the plumbing in my house. So, Krishnaraj, to conclude, it is of dire importance that the fire-related issues discussed are dealt with post-haste by a professional. Should a similar issue relating to fire safety arise in the UK, it would be standard procedure for the fire authorities to do an inspection. And if problems relating to fire safety were found, the whole tower would be evacuated. I have attached 2 links below to validate this statement. And there are 2 links here from The Guardian. One of them is titled, "London Council that evacuated building knew of fire door problem 5 years ago." And another is called, "Camden to evacuate Taplow Tower over fire safety fears after Grenfell disaster." Now, both of these links I will be pasting in the description below the video, below this video. So this was the letter here. Matthew Thomas concludes his letters by saying, "Regards, Matthew Thomas." I'm going to paste these links in the description below. I hope this letter was of guidance to the necessary authorities, and I hope that they will take timely action. Drywall installation and fire protection through drywall installation is a highly technical subject. I am, in all humility, passing on the wisdom that I have acquired, that I am hearing, that I am understanding from an expert, a specialist, a professional. Thank you. Good night.